So let's remember what SPMS, and we, I think we talked about this 2 years ago, صح ولا لا؟ طيب, so what is PMS? What is PMS? شو يعني؟ Before the menstruation. That's reaction here. Okay? Bloating. زي البالونه يعني جسمي راح ينفجر من فوق. اوكي هيدكس اند ذس از ايفن كوايت كنا راح نحكي عنه شوي بالاخر المحاضره. دونت مسلتين اند ويت جيم اللي حكينا عنه نفسها ولا انا جسمي كل مره من فوق مع مي اتسترا. اند سكين ديس اوردرز في شيء نسميه اللي هو اوتو اميون بروجسترون ريليتد درماتايتس. اوكي هلا ذا اكزاكت ميكانيزم وي دونت نو واي some of the theories or theories will it might be high type 1 and hypersensitivity reaction to progesterone or type 4 exactly we don't know why but they can present with any dermatological manifestation بس تاخذوا ان شاء الله dermatology راح تفهموا الصور لحالكم ايش هي. So it has different manifestation, could be urticaria, could be papules, could be like vesicles, okay, different types. It affects almost 15-20% of women. So what are the differential diagnoses whenever we face a patient complaining of these symptoms? Always keep in your mind that this could be depression, this could be panic disorders, could be hypothyroidism, could be anemia. إذا واحدة جاية بجنرالايز فاتيج, insomnia for example, difficulty in concentration, these are symptoms of anemia as well. Fibromyalgia and SLE as well. So always rule out other conditions before diagnosing or confirming if there's a premenstrual symptom or symptom. Okay. Why do some females they have the syndrome and others they don't? Okay, actually it is multifactorial. It could be, it is a combination of genetic factors with environmental, hormonal, and psychological influence. However, the exact mechanism is still not very well understood. There are some of the explanation relating it to the progesterone, that we have normal level of progesterone. However, the response is unusual for the progesterone, and mainly it's due to the metabolite of the progesterone, the allopregnanolone. And what is the allopregnanolone? This is the metabolite of progesterone, which is a strong regulator for the GABA. تعرفوا الجابا؟ مر عليكم أكيد وأكيد رح مر عليكم بس تاخذوا نيورو بعرفوا السكاتي أو لا. Okay. So the GABA is one of the most important neurotransmitters in the brain, and it has an anxiolytic effect and sedative effect. Okay. At high concentration. So it has been proposed that due to the pregnenolone, abnormal response to the pregnenolone affecting the GABA, this can lead to the psychological symptoms of the PMS, and this will be reflected on the types of treatment اللي نحكي عنها بعد شوي. Other possible explanation, those patients they have abnormality in the metabolism of serotonin. كلكم تعرفوا شو أهمية السيروتونين. أوكي رح تحكوا عنه أكثر كمان في السيكات إن شاء الله. أوكي. عشان هيك one of the treatment is related to serotonin effect as well. So it is حقيقة it is an interaction between all these that can lead to the symptoms of PMS. طيب. So what is the treatment? Treatment relies on two concepts or two main things. Number one is the correction of the neuroendocrine abnormality which resulted from the abnormality or the dysregulation in the serotonin metabolism plus the effect of the allopregnanolone on the GABA receptors plus the other thing which we rely on or we try to work on is the suppression of ovulation. طب شو دخل suppression of ovulation في هذا الموضوع؟ حكينا جابا وحكينا سيروتونين حكينا
suppression
of ovulation. لأنه one of the possible mechanisms affecting all these is the sudden change or the shift in the estrogen level. Okay, so once we suppress the ovulation, we will don't have the up and down in the estrogen level. Right. So management starts with non-medical treatment, exercise, and CBT. CBT يعني cognitive behavioral therapy. اللي ما بيعرفها أكيد راح تاخذوا عنها بالسيكاتري. So I'm not gonna talk about it. Medical. The first line of treatment for PMS. لاحظوا إحنا نحكي treatment for PMS syndrome. Okay. Is the SSRIs, which are ish, selective serotonin receptor reuptake inhibitors. I think by now you understood why we can use the SSRI in the treatment. Okay? SSRI is a very good treatment for PMS, and what is good about it that can we start using it for a short duration, 2 weeks only in the luteal phase. If the patient improves, that's fine. If she didn't, then we can use it continuously all through the month. But it's important. Whenever you prescribe SSRI, you should inform your patient about the possible side effects. لأنه بكرة مكتوب لها SSRI تجيكي المريضة with ايش؟ Reduced lipid, بتطلب مشاكل مع زوجها. So if she didn't understand this at the beginning, this might create problems. insomnia and fatigue. These are some of the most common side effects with SSRIs, and they are less when we use it as for shorter duration for 2 weeks. Generally, we prefer using it for 2 weeks. And what is good in SSRIs in the management of PMS, that the effect is almost immediate. It can, the effect, the beneficial effect, can appear within 2 weeks, maximum 4 weeks. I mean, نحكي psychiatric disorders, انت الافكت على SSRI بلش يبين. 6 to 8 weeks, okay? طيب. Now, the second possible option for treatment of PMS, اللي حكينا عنه suppressing the ovulation, اللي هو using estrogen plus progestins, okay? Such as the combined pills or any combination of estrogen and progestin, and we prefer to use a low dose one or the general H agonist in addition to add back therapy. However, it has been recently recommended or has been that COC are not a good option for treating PMS. Okay, unless you are using the combination of drosperinone plus estrogen. Drosperinone is androgenic, anti-androgenic and anti-androgenic effect. And anti-aldosterone effect. Okay, so the most one which can has a good effect is the one with drosperinone. So not any combined pills can be used for PMS. And lastly, this can be used in a very severe factors intractable cases is proceeding with bilateral oophorectomy. Okay, طيب TH يعني plus total abdominal hysterectomy. طب شو دخل اليوترس في الموضوع؟ حنا ليش بدنا نشيل الاوبريس صح؟ Because want to stop the ovulation, want to stop the estrogen, progesterone, etc. طب what about the uterus؟ هذا التاتا شو عوج بالتظبيط؟ مزعج الصورة هيك عوجاء. شو دخل اليوترس؟
أنا
يس
ممكن
إذا
خلينا رح نرجع
نتكلم عليها. يس as simple as that, just to avoid the need for prescribing HRT later on and then نرجع نطلب نفس القصة استروجين بروجسترون etc. Okay. Please pay attention with me لأن هذا مش حاضر في الفوكس ما يكون هالأشياء جديدة اللي راح أحكيها الآن. هذا الشيء التقليدي اللي موجود في كل مكان مكتوب عنه. Okay. ولكن هذولا هلا ريسنتلي عم نحكي عنهم. UPA. What is UPA? It is a uliprocetyl acetate which is selective progesterone receptor modulator. First. Selective progesterone receptor modulator. It has an agonistic and antagonistic effect. Okay. And in this case it works as antagonistic effect. It has been discovered that it has a promising effect in treating premenstrual dysphoric disorders. Okay. UPA was used once for as a medical treatment for fibroid. And then it has been suspended or it's, it has been recommended against using it for fibroids because they discovered it has effect of hepatotoxicity, etc. Thus, it has good results in the premenstrual dysphoric disorders so far. And the dutasteride, what is the dutasteride? It is inhibitor of the 5-alpha reductase which converts with the prenosural alpha, progesterone, the metabolite is allopregnanolone. This enzyme is responsible for converting the progesterone to allopregnanolone. So dutasteride works on this enzyme, inhibits the formation of allopregnanolone, and then it will affect the inhibit the effects of this on the GABA and the central nervous system. And it is one of, we call it one of the off-label use. I think it's off-label use. Yeah, yes, okay, off-label use. We can add, one of the progestin, again, it's being investigated. Dynogest, and this is used in endometriosis as well. Dynogest, it has a very good effect, again, in the PMS. Even much, it's better than the combined pills, okay? Dynogest again is a promising one in treating PMS. What about complementary therapies? ليش دائما بحب احط عنها بعد المحاضرة؟ لأنه قريبا إن شاء الله بتتقرب راح تشتروا بيبيز أو وات ايفر، راح يجيكم أندورين يا دكتور وهذا وناتشورال كلكم بتضحكوا فحاولوا يضحكوا علينا باسمه ناتشورال so it doesn't have the side effects of any medication فلو أخذتوه ده ما ينفع هنشرح الموضوع اتسترا اتسترا. Is this correct? Is this approach is correct? No, why? For two reasons. Why?
Cost.
رقم واحد، there's no evidence. We don't know if it is really efficient or not. رقم اثنين، we don't know if it's safe or not. حتى لو ناتشورال. So what? We don't know. صح ولا لا؟ مظبوط؟ نحكي شوي عن مستوى المايجرين لانه صراحه it's quite common, it's good to be oriented about it. اوكي كلكم تعرفوا ايش يعني مايجرين. في شيء بنسميه, ما عادش مر عليكم هذا المصطلح قبل هيك, منسوا المايجرين وفي منسوا الريليتد مايجرين. هلا both of them they occur mainly on first second day of menstruation and should occur for at least 2 out of 3 cycles عشان نحكم عليه انه related to menstruation. ولكن ما الفرق بين الاثنين؟ انه the menstrual related it occurs at other times other than the menstruation, بينما المنسترول مايجرين اتس اونلي ديورينج منسترويشن. اوكي طيب طلع هون قبل شوي لما حكيت على الاستروجين, وان اوف ذا بوسيبل اكسبلانيشنز اوكي انه ذا فلكتويشن ان ذا استروجين ليفل ويتش افكت ذا نيورو ترانسميترز اند ذا بين ريسبتورز ان ذا برين. اوكي اند ذس ليد تو ذا انكريز ان ذا بين او ذا اتاك ديورينج منسترويشن. طلع هون هذا الكيرف اوف ذا استروجين, في عندنا دروب هون بالاستروجين قد ايش عندنا شارب دروب وذ منسترويشن, اند ذوز بيشنتس ذي هاف migraine mainly during the menstruation. And what is bad about the menstrual migraine that it is more severe and less responsive to medication than the non-menstrual related migraine. Okay. Treatment of menstrual migraine. There is no specific treatment. زي أي migraine. Okay. Simple analgesia or triptans. أتوقع أخذتوا جزء هذا تخطو بالنيورولوجي. أخذتوا أنتوا نيورو ولا لسه؟ أنتوا يوم تخطوها لحال. ماينر. Okay. Triptans is one of the medication which is used in migraine. Okay, and it is advisable to try to use non-oral treatment in this case due to the side effect nausea and vomiting. Non-oral, because triptans there are several forms. It could be oral, could be nasal, could be subcutaneous. Okay, fine. Any question so far? Any question in relation to the menstrual disorders? So you should be able to approach a patient with an ending complaint of menstrual complaints, whether a regular cycle, whether abnormal bleeding, whether dysmenorrhea, be able to differentiate between primary and secondary dysmenorrhea by history. I should be able to differentiate between menstrual symptoms and syndromes and how to approach the initial approach whenever you have a patient complaining of such symptoms. You should be able to differentiate between the normal and the abnormal cycle characteristics. This is very important. Okay. الصبايا اللي قاعدين ورا هناك يا تيجوا هون قدام يا تطلعوا هون قدام. بعدين تيجي المانجمنت. المانجمنت بنركز عنها اكثر شيء في سنسات, بس في اشياء رح نعرج عليهم. تعالوا هون قدام.